the smartest. Yeah, I've made my mistakes, my mistakes. You were there when times were at their darkest, always showing me the way, lead the way. Your love seems to cut me deep, the sharpest. You'll always have a part of me, a part of me. Losing you has always been the hardest. I wish it were the old days, 'cause I was 18 and I still live with my parents. Yeah, they weren't like yours, but yours were more understanding. I never fell in love.
Good morning, this is Wake Up Wildcats. I'm Nadia Tollander.
And I'm Alexandra Delgado. Today is Thursday, May 19th, and it is an A-Day. The weather will be partly cloudy with a high of 90 degrees and a low of 63 degrees.
Today, the cafeteria will serve buffalo chicken wings with a blueberry muffin. Tomorrow, we will have chicken tenders, crispy chicken salad, pepperoni stuffed sandwich, or a peanut butter and jelly while supplies last.
Speaking of lunch, for the last 2 years, all students have received free lunch. Recently, our journalism students took a look into the school lunches and how these changes have affected students and the school.
I'm too lazy to make my own lunch and carry it all the way to school and carry the box all the way home. I've gotten lunch from the cafeteria for as long as I can remember from like freshman year, except for when we were in quarantine.
I've been getting school lunch for about like 3-ish months. I started getting school lunch because I kind of got lazy to bring my lunchbox to school, and I just wanted to start trying the school lunch, so yeah.
I would get rid of the minimum. They require you to get like a juice or like a fruit or vegetable, and I feel like because they require me to get like a fruit or vegetable, it just wastes it because I don't eat them most of the time.
So I have AB days, so I have first and fourth lunch, and first lunch I always get like first pick on everything, but by the time it gets to fourth lunch, there's really like just slim pickings on things. So I would just like the portion control on like just how each lunch is, but that's pretty much the only thing I would change.
Incredibly important. It was a needed thing at the time with the pandemic. I think a lot of people were out of work and they were really struggling financially. So this provided the support for students to eat, and it's another thing that we can do as a division is to support our community. So I thought it was very important. Yeah, I mentioned earlier to you guys, you know, the school lunch program is run as its own entity. I have a good collaborative relationship with our cafeteria manager. I know they're always looking at options to improve what they're serving. Yeah, mainly, usually it's not about the food, it's about the lines. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's too long to wait in lines for lunch, you know, yeah. Those kind of things. And so what I'm trying to do is trying to encourage the kids, although the line's long, don't sit at your table and wait for the line to get shorter, because then once those lines are down, they have to prep for the next lunch, so they're closing those doors and getting ready. Rarely it's about the food. Normally it's about the system. So
a lot. USDA makes us stay in fat and calorie counts for the week. Sugars are reduced, salts are reduced. We have to use anything that has bread or breading on it. It has to be 51% or more whole grains. I do enjoy. I enjoy working with the students. I particularly like being in the high school level. I like interacting with high school kids. But I do enjoy working in school food service. I enjoy the people I work with. It does. This year has been extremely tough, you know. I mean, we are doing twice as many meals as that we've ever done at this high school, serving between 700 to 800 kids daily lunch. So it's hard when you're also short-staffed. We only have 3 of us back there, plus myself.
The last day to check out a library book will be Friday, May 20th, and all library books will be due May 27th. Please start looking for any overdue library books and return them to the library as soon as possible.
Friday is the last day to get your Chick-fil-A sandwich during lunch. Remember, sandwiches are $5 with proceeds benefiting to Graybridge PTSA.
Tonight, girls' soccer will take on Hickory at home, while boys' junior varsity soccer will play Hickory away. Varsity baseball will also be at home tonight against Kings Fork. Tomorrow, varsity baseball will play Hickory away, and varsity softball will play Arcadia at home.
Finally, if you would like your club, activities, or even just you and your friends to be featured in our final intro this year, make sure to send any videos to Ms. Sedley at amanda.sedley@cpschools.com. Also, please make sure the videos are submitted are horizontal instead of vertical. Now time for the joke of the day.
I'm ready.
Why was the math book sad?
Why?
It had too many problems.
Wow.
Well, that's it for today. I'm Nadia Tollander.
And I'm Alexandra Delgado. Wake up, Wildcats.
And make it a great day.